Thanks for being here. Before I start, let me make a confession. I'm not really from gaming. I've not done a lot of work in gaming. What I have done a lot of work on is virality and user acquisition for social products in general. So what I'm going to be talking about today is how do social products, non-gaming social products, acquire users, and what are the lessons that we can learn from there that can then be applied to gaming? And I don't believe in taking a case study and saying, that's what worked there, you've got to do the same thing. It does not apply like that. What I believe in is trying to understand the underlying patterns, the drivers that worked across businesses, and try to see how we can apply those patterns in gaming. So let's get into this. To start with, why is virality so important? A recent study that was done among game players by the IDAR in partnership with the GDC revealed this statistic that the number one reason for new players to sign up for games was social recommendation. We've always known this. There's always been a gut feel around this, but the data also proves that overwhelmingly, social recommendation is the most important reason. Hearing about it from my friends and family, hearing about it on social networks is the most important reason that drives somebody to download a game and play that game. When we talk about social recommendations, I just want to make a distinction over here. We quite often confuse two terms and conflate these two terms, virality and word of mouth. These two terms are actually very different and mean very different things. Word of mouth is what happens when somebody loves your game so much, they just can't stop talking about it. They just have to tell other people about it. Right, so that's word of mouth. Virality is something very different. Virality is an action that the user does while playing your game, while using your product, that exposes your product to other people. So word of mouth very often happens outside a product, and it applies equally well to internet and non-internet offline products. But virality is something that is unique to internet products. It's unique to social products in particular. And usually, virality is an action that the user takes within the game. And word of mouth is something that's very difficult for the business to control. It's very difficult to architect it, to design it. But virality, thankfully, is something that can be designed. And that's what we'll look at in terms of some design patterns that make virality extremely compelling. So when we think of it in the context of games, how do we think of virality? That's what we're just talking about. We always tend to think of it in terms of invites. Invites, that's what virality is about. You go to your Facebook, you have this news feed. Not so much nowadays, but 3 years back, it used to be just full of these hundreds of different invites. And as game developers, we often think of virality as a loop that can be put on top of your game after you've created the game. Whereas actually, it is something that needs to be part of your game. It needs to be part of the workflow of any product. And from my experience doing this for a multitude of social products, I've never seen virality work very well when it's an external loop that's put on the game. It works when it's an external loop put on the product. It works when it's actually part of the product. So far we've been thinking about it in terms of, you know, invites. Grumpy Cat here begs to disagree with that, and most of our users also have a similar reaction about this whole thing. You know, there's just been too much of spam around invites, and wherever there's spam, there's a spam filter. And that's what Facebook did. They installed a spam filter, which was a change in policies. And that's what is eventually going to happen to any platform that you use if you start putting in too much of invites into the whole mix. Because what happens is usually these platforms are very useful if you are the first mover over there, if you're one of the first publishers over there to put up a game. But over time, when there's a saturation of invites, there's user fatigue that comes in, and then there's platform retaliation and spam filtering that comes in as well. So clearly, we're getting something wrong if we're thinking of virality in terms of invites. So let me break the rest of this presentation in two parts. The first part, I'd like to explore, why do invites fail? What is it about invites? What are the underlying psychological factors about invites that make it fail? And secondly, if invites don't work, what does? And I'm going to be focusing more on the design aspect of virality than the optimization, because there's always a lot of focus on how can we make this loop better, how can we make the funnels better, how can we optimize it. But the problem with optimization is if your design is wrong, if your user experience around virality is wrong, by optimizing it, you're actually making the user experience worse. You're actually calling a person to play a game, to have fun, and then making it extremely non-fun for them every time you optimize something that's not good. So let's start with looking at why do invites fail in general. To understand that, let's try to understand what makes virality work in the first place. Here's something I'd like you to think about. Virality is a conversation. Virality is one user telling another, I just used this product, this is what it looks like, and why don't you have a look? It's a conversation at the end of the day. And for a conversation, every conversation is social. And for a conversation, you need to understand that there are two parties involved and that there are two distinct motivations involved. There's a sender who sends out a message about your product, and there's a recipient who gets that message. And the way to structure virality is not to just put an invite loop and keep looking at metrics. The way to do it is first to figure out what are the motivations for the sender to send out the message, and what are the motivations for the recipient to click on it. And these are some patterns that I've seen with a lot of social products that work. So let's look at why senders spread the word in the first place. If you think about senders, these are people who are already playing your game, already using your product. There are three basic motivations for people to spread the word about your product. It makes the product more fun to use when other people come in, and that's what works for, you know, Skype, Facebook, Instagram, all of these social products. It gives me as a user greater fame, and this is what works for gaming on many occasions. You spread out this message whenever the user reaches a new level, that the user has reached level X, or has saved the princess, or has beaten the dungeon master, whatever it be. So there's this whole bragging or fame element involved, which also prompts a user to spread the word. The third reason is fortune, which is inorganic incentives. You spread this and you get new weapons, or you get taken to the next level. Of all these three, the only one that is really organic is the fun part, because the only time that you can really expect your users to repeatedly spread the word is if doing so gives the user greater value out of it. And a classic example of this is Instagram, one of the most viral products that we've ever had. Instagram has such a high virality because spreading a photo onto your Facebook feed creates a conversation around it and makes it more useful for me. Contrast that with a game invite. The game invite is just irrelevant for me as a user. It very rarely helps me to get more value out of the game, unless it's a turn-based game where I can compete with somebody else. So the first question that we need to think about while building virality is, how does spreading this message make it more fun for the user? The second thing is that when you're talking about virality, you're making the user do an action which is part of his whole gaming experience. Now, the user is there to play a game. The user did not download your game to send invites. That was not the reason the user came there. It's a bit like you send out these invitations to people to come to your party, and once somebody's at the party, he gets a tap on his shoulder, and you're standing behind him with a rake and say, go and just take the leaves off my driveway. It's a bit like that, because the user is there for a certain reason. He's there to have fun, and suddenly you've got this whole new invite thing down his throat, and he's not interested in it at all. Usually, if you look at other social products which are really viral, look at YouTube, look at Kickstarter, these are products where the act of spreading the word about the product is part of using the product itself. When I set up a project on Kickstarter, if I tell my friends, if I tell my Twitter followers about that project, I get more value out of it. It's not a separate action that I need to do. It's part of using the product itself. And that's one of the hallmarks of a truly viral product. So the key over here is, how can you make this act of sending something out a part of the gameplay itself, a part of the gameplay that the moment the user takes a break, there's a natural inclination for the user to broadcast something that gives him greater value the next time the user comes back to play the game. The second bit about virality is, you know, why will the recipient of a message take action? Right now, what works against invites is that there are just too many invites on your newsfeed, or used to be too many invites, and it becomes extremely difficult to break through that noise. So let me take a small illustration here. Suppose you're sitting on in your house on a Saturday, and there's this knock on the door, and there's this salesman who wants to sell you a vacuum cleaner. Now, there are two ways that usually salesmen go about this. They have this whole laundry list of product features, and they're talking about, this is a vacuum cleaner, this is these are the various features that it has. Or the salesman can come in, give a demonstration of the vacuum cleaner by cleaning your carpet, and then lock in the sale. More often than not, it's the second salesman who gets better conversions. And that's the problem with invites. Invites tell you what to do. They do not show any damn thing about the product that you have built, about the game that you have. They just tell you what the game is about. And as a user innocently sitting on Facebook, I'm not going to read five different lines telling me what a particular game is about. Contrast this with a product which instantly tells you what it is about on account of what is shared. If you think of Instagram, the moment you see a picture on your Facebook feed, here's the first thought that comes to your mind. This guy who's sharing the picture was never such a good photographer. Clearly, there's something about this app that makes him a good photographer, and that's why I also want to check this app. So you're showing what the product is about. If you think of YouTube, whenever you see a video, if you're seeing it for the first time on your news feed, you realize, hey, this is a place where you can go and get more videos and maybe upload some of your own. So whatever you send out of the product should not just merely be a message. It should be a clear demonstration of what the product is about. Otherwise, there's just too much noise, and it's very difficult to break through that noise. So in general, invites fail because of two things. And just recapping what I just said, they distract the user from the reason that he's there in the first place. Often, they are not useful for the sender of the invite. And secondly, they lead to a lot of spam. They do not show what the product is about. They're just these set of repeated messages that keep coming out of the product. And if you instead think of the show versus tell analogy, if instead of sending a message out as an invite, if you could take a screenshot of the last state of the game and use that as a hook to draw a competitor into the game in a way that the screenshot itself shows exactly what the competitor is supposed to do, that's a better way of showing what the game is about than telling the user that, hey, this is what the game is about and why don't you play. And on that count, there's an interesting experiment by a startup in Sweden called Applifier, which is trying to, what they're trying to do is integrate with games, and whenever the user scores, whenever the user plays a game really well, the app actually records the video of the entire gameplay and allows the user to share that. Now, the reason that's interesting is if you look at what Minecraft, what happened to Minecraft, Minecraft grew huge in a very short time, and a lot of that was attributable to the fact that they had these huge number of YouTube videos which showed the entire gameplay and how new worlds could be created within Minecraft. And that was a case of show versus tell. And what this startup is trying to do is, again, trying to get to show what the product is about, what the game is about, than just tell people about it. So if you think of this, what's most important is that the user should get more value by spreading the word. It should be directly related to the fun aspect of it. It should not be a distraction for the user to actually send out something from the product. And for the recipient, it should show what the product is about. It should not just tell him. So it should show what kind of experience the game can give. It should appeal to the emotion of the recipient than just be a layer of static text trying to pitch what the game is about. So that's the first part of it. Why do invites fail? And those are the three reasons, largely, that invites fail very often. And those are the three, precisely the three reasons why products like YouTube, Kickstarter, and Instagram are so very viral out there. So the next question that this brings us to is, if invites are failing, it's all very good to say invites are failing. It's not the first time we're hearing that. But if invites are failing, what else should we do to actually make this work? What can actually work for us? So let me get back to what I said earlier. Virality is a social interaction. It's something that is about two people talking to each other and one of them saying, why don't you come back and try out this product? Now, the point about any conversation is that the conversation has to be relevant. If I'm talking to you, we should, on a one-to-one basis, we should both be talking about something that's relevant to us, that's personalized to us. It cannot be something that is irrelevant. Now, the reason virality in the form of invites is not a conversation is because the message that is going out is a computer-generated message. And a computer-generated message is just irrelevant. It's not personalized at all. It's just this random message which says, hey, this product is this game is so wonderful. Why don't you come and join this game? The key to succeeding with organic virality is to make that message personalized and make that message extremely specific. So let me take an example of, again, Instagram over here. If you think of Instagram, it's actually a use case. It's actually a sort of game which traditionally was a single player game. You click the picture, you put a filter on top of it, and it remained on your phone. It was purely single player. And that's what Hipstamatic used to do, which Instagram disrupted. So when Instagram came into the picture, it just added a small thing to it. It said, you know what, click a picture, put on a good filter, but now share it as well. Now, the moment it moved from clicking to sharing as the main thing, the value of the product moved from just filters to conversations. And those conversations led to virality. So the key thing over here with Instagram is the reason it became so viral was that it actually encouraged conversations around what was shared. And that is because pictures were actually personal. It was not a random message saying, hey, why don't you come and join me on Instagram? It's a great app to take pictures. Here are some examples. It was not that. It was just a picture coming out of Instagram. In case of YouTube, it's just a video that is shared. And in case of Kickstarter, it's a project that is shared. In case of Quora, if I ask the question on Quora, I send that out on Twitter to my followers for them to reply. In all of these cases, the reason virality works is because it is centered around user-generated content, not around a computer-generated message. And if this has to work for gaming, it again has to work in a way that it is centered around user-generated content. Because that's how it works across social products. There's no reason gaming can be an exception by doling out computer-generated messages. So the key message there is think of the user as a creator. Now, it's very easy to think of the user as a creator when it comes to YouTube, Instagram, Flickr, SlideShare. These are all content platforms. It's very simple to think of who the creator is. But who exactly is a creator in the gaming scenario? Typically, anybody who plays a game, is creating a game state, is creating gameplay. And if there's a way that gameplay, or for asynchronous games, the actual game state can be captured and sent out as a hook for other users to come in, that's a way to build organic virality. And when you think of creations, there's always this pyramid. If you think of the internet in general, there are a lot of people who tweet, a lot of people who click pictures, fewer people who blog or make videos, and still fewer people, the developers, who create actual websites and apps. The same thing happens in gaming. A lot of people, everybody who plays a game creates actual gameplay and actual game states. Some people may take objects of the game and customize it, like avatars. And some people might actually create these objects within the game. So if you really want to exploit virality to the maximum, you need to be at the bottom of this pyramid. Find a way so that every time a user plays a game, that gameplay or that game state can be captured and can be sent out externally as an image, as a video, as some other form that actually shows what the game is about. So there, essentially, if we were to combine everything that I talked about today, there are three questions that we need to answer over here. What is it that the user creates on the game that doesn't require any additional effort? Because the user is not there to create something to make your game go viral. It should be part of the gaming experience itself. Secondly, does this thing that the user creates deliver him more value when he actually shares it with other users out there on an external network, especially with his friends? Is the game something that becomes more interesting when friends come in? And thirdly, when the user shares something out there, how can we make it an accurate demonstration of what the game is about, of what the game is all about, so that the recipient of this content that the user has created finds it extremely relevant, extremely engaging, and at the same time gets a demonstration of what the game is about. So I don't want to give you the three recommendations that you definitely have to work with on your game. What I want to leave you with three principles that you need to, in general, think about when you're designing your game and when you're thinking of creating organic virality within your game. Because these are essentially the principles that work for social products across the board. And once you have the design right, that's when optimization comes into the picture. So again, to finally recap the whole discussion, invites are dead, but shareable and spreadable content might just do the trick. It's already doing the trick for other social products out there. So is there a way that you can use content created within the game, spread that out, and get users to come in based on that content as a hook on an external network? So thank you so much for being here. That was the key message that I wanted to leave you with. And if you have any questions even after this talk about how this could be applied directly to your game, I'm happy to discuss that with you. Thank you.
Thank you, Sangeet. You know, you're doing something that is really rare, I think, in this industry, which is really thinking about the viral content and the user interaction loops from the very, very beginning in terms of what's happening in the game that makes somebody want to share, all the way to the very, very end, which is I've responded and I've actually gotten some benefit out of that interaction. This is smart stuff. Any questions for Sangeet? Looks like you blew all their minds.
Great, thanks.
All right, thank you very much.
Thank you.
I will get the next speaker hooked up and we'll keep rolling through our program this afternoon.